Friends, welcome to the Classic Education YouTube channel. I am Dr. R.V. Chitgopi, the faculty of history at Classic KS and IS Study Circle, Dharwad. Today, I am with a new subject, which is also important for the competitive examinations and also here to the common man. Today we are taking the excursion of the charismatic gardens of India. This is the subject I have chosen, and there are some charming gardens of India which we are taking the journey there. So here, the laying of the gardens was the aesthetic expression of the human beings and their skill. And this is one of the ancient art which has developed in different parts of India as well as the world. For instance, if you go back to the Mesopotamian civilization under the Babylonian civilization, we had the famous garden, the hanging gardens laid down at Babylon in Iraq, what we have got today. The mainly hanging gardens, which was one of the seven wonders of the ancient world, laid down by the Babylonian king Nebuchadnezzar II. It is a terraced garden, or we call it as the step garden here, or pyramidical garden, the hanging gardens of Babylon. Then in many of the Greek and Roman records, we have the evidences of these gardens. The gardens were laid down here with the intention to give the beautiful look, the charming look to their masons and the palaces. Different types of gardens have been laid down. Like it may be the garden of the fruit trees, or it may be the garden of the flowers, or it may be the garden of the medicinal plants, so on. The Persians here during the medieval period, we see, developed the art of the growing of the gardens in the Central Asian region. And in India, here to speak about the growth of this art of laying of the gardens is one of the ancient art, we can say, because we have got a lot of references to the gardens here in the epics Ramayana and Mahabharata. Then we have the here mainly references of the Ashokan edicts laying here the gardens, the where medical plants were laid down, the fruit gardens were laid down for the welfare of the people. Followed by that, a 12th century book, an encyclopedia entitled Manas Ullasa, written by King Someshwara III of the later Chalukyas, or the Chalukyas of Kalyan in Karnataka. We have a new style of garden which developed here, modeled on the Persian gardens, called as the Charbagh, where the gardens were equally here divided into four parts with the beautiful mainly the waterways and the here mainly the walk paths. So the Charbagh gardens, it was the Mughal contribution to here India. And along with this, we find here huge gardens were laid down, independent gardens were laid down. And we find these gardens were the pleasure resort for the Mughal rulers. So this is what, how the Mughals were mainly responsible for the growth of the here the garden art in India. Later we have the Britishers also continued it in the colonial period. The Britishers also continued this. And here after independence, India has also, the central government, the state governments, the NGOs, the private persons are taking more interest to develop these gardens, to beautify their houses, to beautify their mainly the cities. Here these gardens are today here a part of the social life. And we find the study of this gardens has given rise to a new science here called as horticulture. Horticulture is the study of gardens. It has come from the word hortus. Hortus is a Latin word which means garden. Horticulture that has developed, and we find here M.H. Marigouda is known as the father of the Indian horticulture, who gave more importance to the study of this and laying of these gardens. So, well, friends, here today we are going to take here the excursion of here some of the famous gardens of India. I'll be touching only the important gardens of India, which are mesmerizing and here charismatic. So, here we start our mainly the journey of the gardens from mainly Jammu and Kashmir capital, the Srinagar. So, we are going to start with Srinagar. Here the very famous gardens we have got. So, namely, we have got four important gardens at Srinagar. Srinagar is one of the place which is located on the Dal Lake, which is here mainly made by the river Zelam. Zelam is responsible for making of this Dal Lake, and it is on the banks of this Dal Lake we have these beautiful gardens. Namely, the Shalimar Garden, the Nishant Bagh, and the Shalimar Bagh, and the recently developed the Tulip Gardens, the four important gardens of Srinagar. The Shalimar Garden, Chashme Shahi Bagh, Nishant Bagh, and the Tulip Gardens. These are the four important gardens what we have got in Srinagar. So, the first three, that is Shalimar Bagh, Nishant Bagh, and Chashme Shahi Bagh, they are the Mughal gardens laid down during the time of the Mughal Emperor Jahangir and Shahjahan. Later Shahjahan. So, the period of these two emperors saw the laying of these gardens. So, we find this particularly here the Mughal emperors laid down these huge gardens, built here palaces in these gardens to spend their mainly the summers. That was what it was, a pleasure resort for them, particularly the Nishant Bagh, the here garden of pleasure. It was the abode of the pleasure there. The Shalimar Bagh and the Chashme Shahi Bagh, here variety of flower plants are laid down, and when they bloom up, it is one of the pleasant sight what we get in these gardens. One feels here the thrilling experience and the mesmerizing sight of these flowers. However, the visitors here to the Kashmir visit these places here, but the recent development what we have got is the tulip garden. Tulip is one of the here flower which is grown in the cold region, and it is the tulip garden which has been laid down in Srinagar. However, to mention it, the tulip flower was known to the Mughals, and one of the most beautiful tulip flower painting we have got of Ustad Mansur, who was the royal painter of the Jahangir's court. He has painted the red tulip flower. And you can see multicolor tulip flowers in this Srinagar tulip garden. And the blossoming period of this is very short. It is here by the end of February, March, April. So this is the blossoming period, and this is the time to visit to see the tulips, because this is the only place where you can see the tulips in India. The tulip flowers are seen. Here the colors. Here we have got different colors, red, yellow, here blue, white, violet. Here these colors, here mainly we can see that the carpets of these colors have been laid down on the earth. In that way, the here mainly the flowers are grown. So these are some of the here famous gardens what we have got in Srinagar. So one who pays here visit to Srinagar, he has to visit these gardens. Apart from this, here he has to take here the Shikara ride in the Dal Lake. So that is the thing what here mainly makes the Kashmir trip or Jammu Kashmir trip, Srinagar trip a memory. Well, after Srinagar, friends, we are moving to another important place, Chandigarh. So Chandigarh has got three important gardens. From Chandigarh, 22 kilometers away, we have got a garden called as the Pinjora Garden. It is also a Mughal garden, but it has been renovated and given a new look here. And this is a popular spot here for the people of Chandigarh to get relief from their stress and here go to the weekends. So this mainly the garden has got the beautiful fountains, the mainly the blooming here flowers and the lush green creepers and the shady trees. So this is a very popular spot here for the people of Chandigarh to go for their picnics. So this is one of the garden which is very locally popular. The Pinjora Gardens, originally it was a Mughal garden. And in proper Chandigarh, we have got two important gardens. The Rose Garden, which has got variety of roses of different colors, different shades, multicolor shade roses can be seen here. So the Rose Garden is to be visited. These are mainly here the roses what we have got here. Very some of the here rare roses which we cannot find in other parts of India can be seen at Chandigarh. Some of the roses which are of the Central Asian origin here are planted. So these roses here mainly are one of the attraction for the visitors during their blooming season. Usually the blooming season of the flowers is after November and before March. After November to before March, this is almost the blooming season of the flowers there. So visitors can visit here the Rose Garden during this period. But the most outstanding garden of Chandigarh is the Rock Garden, popularly called as Nek Chand Rock Garden. So it is named after the person who was the creator of this garden, Nek Chand. It is very interesting to note here that he has made this huge garden here out of the waste. So whatever waste was there, here the waste materials in the building, here when the waste materials were there, so using those stones, wood, iron, here using this mainly the store here, the waste materials, this garden has been created. It is a huge garden and we have got many here the things to watch, the human figures, the mainly village life, the social life here, the mainly the here we have got the ponds, the lakes, the waterfalls. So it is all created here out of the waste. So that is here mainly here Nek Chand was one of the person who was responsible for this creation. And a person visiting Chandigarh should not forget to visit here this rock garden. It is a must to be seen. That is what we have got in Chandigarh here, and it's nearby the three gardens. Moving from Chandigarh, we come to the capital of India, that is Delhi, where we have got the Mughal gardens in front of the Rashtrapati Bhavan. Rashtrapati Bhavan has the Mughal gardens, and we have got a variety of plants, variety of flowers grown here, and it is allowed for the public here between the month of March and April. The public are allowed to see the only the garden portion. So the Rashtrapati Bhavan gardens are popularly called as the Mughal gardens, modeled on the Shalimar gardens of Srinagar. So these are what we have got in Delhi here, one important garden, followed by that Lodi Gardens, which is mainly named after the king who laid down this garden. It was Sikandar Lodi. The famous gardens, Lodi Gardens, and within that complex we have got the tomb of Sikandar Lodi also. So popularly called as the Lodi Gardens. Here is mainly here the lush green lawn, and it is the most popular spot to take the morning and the evening walks for the people of Delhi. So we see lot of people jogging, skipping, taking a brisk walk in these gardens in the morning and in the evening there. This is mainly what we have got in Delhi, the two gardens here that can be seen here. So moving from Delhi, now we go to here Rajasthan. In Rajasthan at Jodhpur, so a new creation has been made called as Rao Jodha Desert Rock Garden. It is a very recently started garden what we have got. One can notice here in this the flora and fauna of the desert. So Jodhpur here was mainly the city that was built by Rao Jodha. So it is the mainly the garden is named after the mainly the architect of the city as Rao Jodha. So he was responsible for the establishing the city of Jodhpur, and this is the capital of the Marwad region of Rajasthan. So Marwad and Mewad, two parts we have got. The Marwad part capital is the Jodhpur, where we can find the desert life. So the three districts here mainly Jodhpur, Bikaner and Jaisalmer, they form here the three districts. They are called as the desert districts, where we find the Thar desert. And how is the flora and fauna of this desert life can be seen at this garden? It is here from Jodhpur. It is located at a distance of 10 kilometers. From Jodhpur, it is located at a distance of 10 kilometers. So where we have got also the famous fort, the Mehrangarh Fort. Below that, we have got this garden. Here, visitors can take a journey of the Mehrangarh Fort, which is worth visiting here, and also about this flora and fauna of the desert in this. We have got a lot of natural stones. The formation of the natural stones, which are formed because of the volcanoes, craters, and the sandstone creations. And along with that, we come across here, if the visitors are lucky, they can witness some of the birds which come for the breeding here. It is also a breeding place for some of the birds. You can watch some of the birds, and also we can see some of the here mainly the life of the animals of the deserts. And one can take a journey, or they can ride on the camels to have a look at this garden. So this is a very recent creation, and it is one of the attraction for the tourist. Tourist visiting the Mehrangarh Fort can visit this mainly the desert garden. So these are the different mainly I'm speaking about the gardens which attract the tourist, and the tourist planning to go to this place can include in their itinerary. Moving from there, here to Rajasthan, I am coming to Gujarat. At Gujarat, just 5 kilometers away from the capital Gandhinagar, you have got a new garden that is there, the Garden of the Dinosaurus Fossil Garden. So huge dinosaurs here, the models have been made and they have been displayed. So this is very interesting for the youths, for the elders, as well as for the children. One can know how the dinosaurs were there and how the dinosaurs lived. Here we have the models or the replicas of the dinosaurs eggs displayed in this mainly the garden. So it is an educative for mainly the children. We can come to know about here how these dinosaurs lived, when they lived, and why they became extinct. Today no more we see these dinosaurs. Only it is these evidences we have found of the dinosaurs, and this fossil park is one of the things which can help the people to know what were the dinosaurs, how they lived, and what was mainly the shape of the dinosaurs, how hefty they were, how gigantic they were. So these are all the things which can be learnt by visiting this, mainly the garden. And this is popularly called as the Jurassic Park of India. This garden is known as the Jurassic Park of India there. This is here we have got at Gandhinagar, the mainly the dinosaurus fossil garden. Moving from there, coming to Maharashtra, Mumbai, where we have the Hanging Gardens of Mumbai. At a high altitude on a small hill on the shores of Arabian Sea, the Hanging Gardens here are also popularly known as the Firoz Shah Mehta Gardens. So this is one of the garden here to spend the evenings. The cool breeze from the sea here makes you refreshed. And the people of Bombay here flock to this here place here to spend their evenings. And you will find the street hawkers selling the eatables there. One of the most here amazing sight in this hanging garden is the sunset. So people sitting in the garden, they watch here sun slowly going down in the Arabian Sea. It is a pleasure to the eyes. The sunset point is one of the main attraction of this garden there, the Hanging Gardens of Mumbai. From there, we proceed further, coming to Hyderabad. Coming to Hyderabad, we have got the NTR Gardens and the Husseini Sagar, the Hussein Sagar. So one of the popular hub for the local people as well as the visitors. So usually we find that the people in the evenings as well as in the weekends, people come to this place and they spend their mainly the leisure time. We have got a lot of activities for the children. Video games are there, many here games are been displayed there, and street hawkers are there with a variety of here the eatables. The souvenir shops are there, textile shops are there, so where the purchases can take place. The costume here shops are there. So like this, it is one of the here a commercial hub here for the people of Hyderabad. And to get a here relief, they can also take here a boat ride in the Husseini Sagar around the statue of Gautam Buddha in the middle of the lake. So these are mainly the very interesting aspects what we have got about the gardens. So gardens are always refreshing here. To refresh oneself, the mainly people move to these gardens. Coming from there, here the Karnataka. Karnataka in the here capital Bangalore, or today known as Bengaluru. Here, this city saw the laying of the beautiful gardens right from 18th century here during the rule of here Hyder Ali. Hyder Ali period saw the laying of the gardens. Later on, here many gardens were laid down in Bangalore during the time of the Wadiyars. So particularly it was Diwan Mirza Ismail who was responsible for the laying of many gardens in Bangalore, and that is the reason why the city got the name as the city of gardens in India. Bangalore is known as the city of gardens in India. The most here popular garden and the most fascinating here garden of Bangalore is the Lal Bagh. Lal Bagh, which is here laid down by Hyder Ali. Hyder Ali laid down this garden, and here we have got the variety of roses here plants, and when they bloom, it is here amazing to the eyes. It gives a pleasure to the eyes. Not only that, at the entrance of the Lal Bagh, one of the most interesting aspect what we can see is the flower clock. The flower clock is a very popular spot where the children come and they watch this flower clock. The flower clock is at the entrance, and it is in the middle of this garden. Here we have the glass house. the landmark of Bangalore, the glass house. And here every year the horticulture department organizes the flower shows in this Lal Bagh garden. And every year a new theme is there for the flower decoration. And it is one of the attraction of the people here of Bangalore as well as surroundings, and people move from other states to see that flower show, which runs for 3 days. It is one of the revenue generating here activity in Bangalore, the flower show at Lal Bagh. So very famous gardens of here Bangalore what we have got. This is one of the here the garden what we have got. Further moving here from Bangalore to Mysore, so where we have the gardens called as here the Brindavan Gardens. Beside Krishnarajasagar Dam or Kannambadi Dam, the Brindavan Gardens laid down during the period of Diwan Mirza Ismail. So this garden is modeled on the Mughal gardens with colorful fountains, and here between 7 and 8 in the evening we have the here musical fountain show in this garden. There is a small lake where here boating can be done. Pedal boats are also available. You can here on your own pedal the boats. So these are here mainly, and we have got here the garden, the mainly the flower shows are there in the Brindavan Gardens. Lot of mainly cafeterias have been established for the convenience of the visitors. You can find the eatables, beverages at this place. One of the most pleasure resort, what we can say here, the Brindavan Gardens, which was completed in 1931, and this garden was inaugurated by the then Viceroy of India, Lord Irvine. He inaugurated this garden, the Brindavan Gardens, one of the famous gardens here. Along with the Krishnarajasagar Dam, you can also have a glance of this garden there. So Mysore is known for these gardens. Moving from Mysore to Tamil Nadu now, here Ooty, the botanical garden or the government botanical garden, which is here one of the popular spot for the Bollywood movies here as well as the Tollywood movies, the Sandalwood movies. Lot of here picturization takes place in the botanical garden of Ooty. A very huge garden it is. The mainly botanical garden has got here the flora of different varieties. Lot of species of the flora, the plants are available here. One can get a lot of information about here the plants that are noticed here. And it is one of the educative garden. We find a lot of students coming here to study, particularly the students of botany. They come to this place here for their educational studies. So that is what we have got at Ooty, a very famous botanical garden. And it is also visitors when they go to this place. One of the point where we have here the mainly the map of India in the flowers that has been made in the lawn. And that is the most picture sequence here. You can have the photographs at this place there. So Ooty Gardens, what we have got mainly here in Tamil Nadu, or that is Udagamandalam, it is also known as, or Utakma. Moving from Ooty here to Kerala, the last place which I am taking is the Mallam Fadza Gardens and the Tea Gardens of Munnar, the two very exciting gardens of here Kerala. The Mallam Fadza, on the way to Munnar, Munnar is a hill station in Kerala and known for its tea gardens. And while moving here, we get this garden here at Mallam Fazza. Mallam Fazza garden is also a huge garden, and it is one of the picnic spot for the people there. The two main attractions of this garden are mainly in the Mallam Fazza. Here you have got a lake where speedboat ride can be taken. Very exciting speedboat ride we have got it. That is one of the things which cherishes the minds of here the people there. And another way, here another attraction is at the center of this garden. At the top on the, we have a ropeway by which you can take the aerial view of the full garden when you travel by that ropeway. These are the two very popular attractions of this Mallam Fazza garden. And from Mallam Fazza to Munnar, when we move, you will see on your left and the right side the tea gardens, people working there. So here mainly people will be working, and we have plenty of the time here to stop there, and you can take the photographs with the local people, and also you can have the dresses of the local people worn and take here mainly the photographs wearing that tea baskets at your back, which the local people use for plucking off the tea leaves. So these are some of the interesting aspects which makes the journey from Mallam Fazza to Munnar very interesting. So gardens here, these are the most well-known gardens what we have got in India. So gardens are mainly a peace to the mind. They bring a relief to your stress. And here they refresh yourself. And not only that, they are educative in nature also. So here there are many attractions when you go to the places, and if you find any gardens here in that place, please do visit that. And if you have an opportunity to go to these places which I have mentioned, do visit these gardens and get refreshed there. With this, we end the journey of the gardens here. And once again, I'll be back with you with another very interesting aspect here, which can be educative, also here amazing, exciting, and thrilling there. So with this, I conclude my session. And viewers, if you have not subscribed for the Classic Education channel, YouTube channel, do subscribe to it. I will be back once again with you. Thank you.